Senator from Alabama.
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President, I rise today on behalf of the line workers at our Alabama auto plants. And I rise on behalf of our soybean and cotton farmers. And I rise on behalf of countless other Alabama businesses that have contacted me because they feel threatened by proposed tariffs, but are afraid to speak out publicly for fear of reprisal, or in some cases, they simply don't want to be seen as inflicting political damage to the president. Mr. President, I came to this body to work on solutions, not to raise partisan threat levels. So I'm not one to unfairly level criticism at the President of the United States. But I have and I will continue to call it like I see it, when his actions hurt our economy and my state in particular. Today I want to talk about his proposed tariffs on our allies and our trading partners. These actions have prompted retaliatory tariffs on countless Alabama goods, including cotton and soybeans. American industries overwhelmingly oppose these tariffs, or really, their taxes on their products. Mr. President, I share President Trump's desire to see continued growth in our manufacturing sectors and to secure trade deals that benefit our country. But his tariffs are not leading to more manufacturing jobs in Alabama. Instead, they have manufactured a crisis that threatens to permanently harm our businesses and our farms. Mr. President, this is a self-inflicted wound. I am well aware that China has been a rogue actor when it comes to trade, and I support a strong response. Alabama's steel industry, for example, was hurt by the illegal dumping of Chinese steel into the global market. I witnessed firsthand in my hometown of Fairfield, Alabama, once home to one of the country's largest U.S. steel facilities that now sits virtually idle. Globe Metallurgical in Selma has been hit by the dumping of silicon metal from China. And China has time and again shown a blatant disregard for American intellectual property rights. I've spoken out against these abuses and will continue to do so when they occur in the future. But we should not sweep our friends with the same brush as we sweep China. Antagonizing allies like Canada, South Korea, and Germany for no reason at all only weakens us. According to the U.S. Chamber of Commerce, more than 500,000 Alabama jobs are supported by global trade, meaning more than 1 in every 4 Alabama jobs is tied to trade, and those jobs are needlessly at risk today. Mr. President, I have spoken with representatives from industries across my state. Some are already hurting from the tariffs. Others are okay for the moment, but are fearful of consequences down the road, such as losing suppliers or taking a direct hit from retaliatory tariffs. Many of these workers or business owners tell me they support President Trump. They want him to do well. They voted for him, and they're hesitant to speak out because they don't want to appear to be disloyal or harm him politically. But they're confused as to why the president is taking steps that hurt their businesses and put their jobs at risk, and they won't help. They say what we in this body already know. Tariffs are nothing more than tax increases. They are taxes that hurt American businesses, American workers, American consumers, and the American economy. In a cruel twist, they seem to be doing the most damage in the places and sectors that make up the president's base of support. Farmers, auto workers, truck drivers, these are the exact folks he promised to take care of. Nowhere is that more prevalent and evident than in our automotive industry. But it's not just really an industry as we think of it in abstract terms. It means people and jobs and families, the ability to support that family. One of those people is a man named John Hall. John's been a maintenance worker at the Hyundai Motor Manufacturing Plant in Montgomery, Alabama, for nearly 14 years. He recently came to Washington to tell folks about what the industry has meant to his community. At a rally last Thursday, he said that the transformation of Montgomery and the Alabama River region has been breathtaking, breathtaking since the Hyundai plant arrived in our state. He went on that day to testify at the Commerce Department at a hearing about whether or not imported automobiles, trucks, and parts posed a national security threat. Now that bears repeating. These tariffs on automobiles, foreign automobiles and parts, are being proposed because somehow, some way, foreign vehicles and parts are a threat to national security. I don't know how else to say it. That's just a ridiculous premise, and everyone knows it. Even the president implicitly acknowledged that in one of his Twitter rants this week, just the other day when he threatened to raise auto tariffs in response to the antitrust fine levied against Google by the European Union. Not only is it not a national security threat, this industry has brought untold opportunity to Alabama and other states, particularly in the Southeast. Before the automakers came to Alabama, our manufacturing industry was still reeling from NAFTA. Many Alabama facilities, like textile manufacturers, were closing down and moving to other countries. But these automakers came to Alabama. Mercedes, Honda, Hyundai, Toyota's engine factory, and now a Toyota and Mazda automobile factory breaking ground soon. And they have breathed new life into our economy. And they've all announced plant expansions in the last year or so. Alabama's automotive sector employs some 50,000 people. And motor vehicle exports from Alabama reached $11 billion in 2017. Simply put, Alabama is a trade state, an exporting state. It's not just cars either. We export about $170 million annually in soybeans to China, and that industry contributes about 11,000 jobs to our state. The day that China released its list of U.S. goods that could be tariffed, soybean prices fell 40 cents that morning. Stan Ussery, the president of the Alabama Soybean and Corn Association, and a soybean farmer said, quote, "If you weighed that out in dollar figures, it was in the billions of what the value of the U.S. soybean crop lost in just that one day, just based on the fear of an imposed tariff," end quote. I've heard from other farmers, too. Peanut contract prices have fallen flat. Pork prices have fallen $18 a head since March. Cotton prices dropped 10 cents in the wake of initial round of tariffs. Our cattle farmers share these concerns and are anticipating potential production cost increases as a result of more expensive fuel and grain. And just yesterday, we learned that the administration is going to spend $12 billion in taxpayer money to help offset the damage its trade war has done to American farmers. These farmers need the money. It is a self-inflicted wound, but they need it. This money might help some of these farmers somewhat in the short term. But, Mr. President, it is a slippery slope for the President of the United States to start down. What about the meat packers who see less work because of reduced sales, or truck drivers who transport these goods across the country? These folks won't trade, not aid. And tariffs, they're not reversed soon. The damage to supply chains and markets cannot be undone. You see, Mr. President, a company like Harley-Davidson can move a plant from Wisconsin overseas to avoid tariffs. My farmers in Alabama just can't do that. You can't move a soybean farm. You can't move a cotton field. You can only move plants and hardware and people. China is one of the top markets for Alabama's cotton, poultry, pork, and soybeans. China chooses to source these goods from Brazil, Australia, or Vietnam to avoid the president's tariffs. They'll not go back to purchasing from Alabama once common sense prevails and the tariffs are rescinded. By then, it will be too late. A market is lost, and family farms cannot recover from the loss of the business. Now, I know some folks back home in Alabama, they just don't like it when the president gets criticized. They certainly don't like it when I do, and I understand that. They don't like it even when it may hurt the policies of the administration, may hurt Alabama. One of my own delegation colleagues in the House went so far as to suggest that we shouldn't be worried about these automobile tariffs. They were all getting worked up over nothing. Well, I kind of like to think he's right, but I don't think he is. And neither do the thousands of folks who work in Alabama's automobile industry or their family members who have written or called my offices. Nor do the industry representatives they have sent to Washington to plead with their elected officials for help. Nor does my good friend, the senior senator from Tennessee, who I'm proud to be standing here with today. I believe these tariffs are bad for Alabama and bad for America. Senator Alexander, who is a strong supporter of the president on many issues, agrees that these tariffs represent a very real threat to the hundreds of thousands of jobs in the automotive industry. And no region in the country would be hit harder than the Southeast, where textiles used to be king, but where automobiles now reign supreme. That's why I'm here today, to stand up for my constituents, to do what I think is right. It's why last month that Senator Alexander and I wrote to Commerce Secretary Wilbur Ross, urging him to reconsider the auto tariff tax proposal before it damages the automotive sector, which contributes more than 200,000 jobs to our two states. It's why I've reached out to the Commerce Department and U.S. Trade representatives on behalf of a number of Alabama businesses, from textiles to heating and air conditioning companies to businesses in the energy sector, each facing their own unique crisis because of proposed tariffs. In fact, since I was sworn in, I've invited representatives from a number of impacted industries to come to my office to share their stories, offer suggestions on what we can do, and to be honest about outcomes if we fail to act. Mr. President, I did not come to this body to simply sit by and watch and do nothing, especially when I see a need and I need to step up. I said I would follow my conscience, do the right thing to make Alabama and America a better place. In that spirit, short time earlier today, Senator Alexander and I followed up on our letter to Secretary Ross, to which, quite frankly, we've not yet received a response, by introducing the Automotive Jobs Act of 2018. It's a bipartisan effort to halt President Trump's proposed tax on imported cars, trucks, and auto parts that will raise the price of every automobile produced in the United States. Our legislation would require the International Trade Commission to conduct a comprehensive study of the well-being, health, and vitality of the United States automotive industry. The ITC will be required to deliver the report to Congress before these tariffs could be applied. Tariffs should be used to protect American jobs, not hurt them. In the coming weeks, I'll be looking at other legislative solutions to help other sectors impacted by the president's tariffs. But the president can save our auto industry today by simply calling off the 232 investigation. If we are not vigilant, hardworking Alabamans are going to be the losers in this game of chicken with China, the European Union, and others. The small family farmers, the line workers at our auto plants, the truck drivers who transport Alabama-made products to market, our port, all stand to lose the gains that we've made in the last couple of decades. It's my hope that through this legislation, we can demonstrate beyond any doubt the positive benefits the auto industry brings to Alabama, Tennessee, and many other states across the country. Instead of pursuing these tariffs, we should be partnering with our allies, who have also been treated unfairly by countries like China, to present a united front against bad actors and their harmful trade practices. I believe in the great potential of our nation's automobile industry, and I want to empower both the American and foreign automakers who have already invested significantly in this country. This is a thriving industry, one supported by the greatest workforce in the world, that's helped it continue to grow and support good-paying jobs in our communities. We need to stand united against these proposed tariffs. President Trump, Alabamians are counting on you to do the right thing by those who stood with you. I hope you will do so. Mr. President, at this time, I'd like to ask unanimous consent to yield to my friend, Senior Senator from Tennessee, Senator Alexander.
Senator from Tennessee.
Thanks, Mr. President.